This could be the best mechanism I've ever seen. Oh, look at that. Smooth. Well, Gary, I'd like to present you with a present.
Oh, finally, some recognition for all those years working in the electrical industry. Thank you, Gordon.
And you might think it's a bottle of champagne. It certainly looks like one.
I hope it is.
But as Joe Robinson described in earlier videos, this is the champagne of the electrical industry. It's the Proxima socket from Scame. And one of the finest boxes on the outside we've ever seen. Inside is one of the finest enclosure systems that we've seen as well. And we're going to take a closer look at it in today's video.
Okay, let's get this one out then. It is a fantastic box, and inside it is a fantastic enclosure. And you've already suggested at the very start of this video you love the mechanism. We'd love your comments, so please make sure you fire them in below. Which great features do you like on this product from Scame?
Yeah, so yeah, the mechanism, yeah, it's one of the standout features because it's lovely and smooth. But actually, the whole product is lovely and smooth. Because obviously in industrial environments, sometimes we're worried about dust and dust gathering in places. But yeah, here's just revisit that mechanism. Yeah, it's got no edges and bits that protrude, and that continues when you look at the switch as well. It's flush with the body, so it's, again, not likely to get damaged in that industrial environment. And then down to the socket itself. So again, open that up there.
Yeah.
So here's another clever bit. So obviously you turn it to get the IP 66, 67 or 69 rating.
Yep.
We've looked at a lot, the difference between them on the channel before. But interesting feature, if you actually leave this open, because people tend to be a little bit lazy sometimes, and I just leave that in that position, it gets an IP54 rating.
Oh wow, that is really good. I notice at the very top there we have no overcurrent protection devices fitted. So should we whip the cover off and start discussing those sorts of things?
Yeah, so I'll just have a look inside.
You have a little go in there.
So this, it comes as either a socket version.
Okay.
Or you can have the top version added where you're right, you can add circuit breakers. It also has an enclosure option as well, where you might want to put contactors in there and things that you don't need to access behind the a panel.
And again, this goes back to your comments. I think that's a fantastic idea, having your RCD protection, especially we're almost impossible to get away with it not having it on a socket outlet circuit, even though this one goes up to 63 amps, doesn't it? Okay, there's different, slightly different arrangements when we get to that level for RCD protection. But we go back to the distribution board, we look in there and we're now thinking, oh, we haven't got any RCDs in there or any RCD protection. We've either got to try and order that overcurrent protection device or try and fit it in. Isn't it a lot easier to have it local to it? And we made our challenge really difficult as well, didn't we, for our RCD for this one?
Yes, we did, yes. We've got here a type B. We can fit that. And try and just, I mean, I'll leave that there.
Yeah, try and get a type B in anything, let alone to match the distribution board in the installation where you might think a type B is needed. We might be a little bit early with this one, but as RCDs are developing and the protection required and the different types, we think type B will become a lot more common as the years pass. So you're undoing this enclosure.
So the other challenge there, Gary, you've described an RCD, but obviously back at the distribution board, you have to combine it with some overcurrent protection as well, which means you need a combination of RCD and MCB, and try getting that in something that fits in a three-phase board, and you're into either very large units or and quite expensive units.
Okay, so let's get the enclosure open then. I'm getting pretty excited. Right, so something else. That's a nice little touch, isn't it?
Yeah, so there's Joe Robinson's lost an excuse there. There's a spirit level inside.
Yeah, Wonky Joe will be pleased to see that. Obviously, we've got our ability there to just pop things onto that rail. Okay, open up the outlet. Is it pre-wired?
It is pre-wired as well.
Oh, right. Okay, that's brilliant, isn't it? So that saved ourselves some time. We've seen these before, haven't we? Yeah, as we look in there, I've got a torque settings clearly on the front as well, something else eFIXX like.
Yeah, this is pre-wired, so you just take that up to the chosen circuit protection that you need. It's an interlocked socket, so obviously we can't operate that at the moment because it's got no switch in it.
Okay, got a socket there, I've got to put the plug in, yeah? Okay, and now we can operate it.
Yeah, and we can see our interlocking device.
Just do that again for us. Yep, see that mechanism moving, yeah.
Nice, robust unit.
But look at the corners. You know, this is like, you know, when cars went from square to nice smooth round edges and we saw the finer details. That is beautifully detailed, isn't it?
You're thinking back to your Sierra, Gary.
I am, yes, when the Mondeo came out with all those curvy edges.
And then to look at the enclosure itself, some of the clever features on here in terms of mounting. So we've got external mountings.
Oh, right, okay, let's have a look at that. Yeah, so external mountings on that. So that means we can maintain that IP rating. I'll bring the camera back in for that. That's really good, isn't it?
Yeah.
So the IP rating continues because we've got these external
fixings. Yeah, so you're not drilling through the back and impeding that IP rating. And again, we've got two at the bottom to latch in.
Oh, right, so you can drop them on as well. Yeah, that's good.
So that's good. And then look at the end. We've got it's pre-marked for various sizes of cable entry.
Yeah, and we've seen that on other isolators that we've done on the channel. We'll leave a link to those videos we've made as well. I like that. It's a nice, subtle, but very good touch, isn't
it? Yeah, so it saves you having to measure things out. And then again, that carries on the bottom of the unit as well.
Scam, you don't miss much out, do they?
Yeah, so we've got a single version here. You can get different combination bases. So again, you could have multiple socket outlets on a base, and obviously that paired with different distribution options. And again, that's a big saving if you're in an industrial application. So I think you had a range of sockets you wanted in a common location. You might have a three-phase, you might have some single-phase sockets. Traditionally, if you're taking all those back to a distribution board, three cables, bigger containment, as we've done in our own unit here, we bring in one cable and separate the circuits locally with local circuit protection and earth leakage protection. That can be a very...
It's got you covered, hasn't it?
It's got you covered, and a big big time saver, and a big, obviously, cost saver when it comes to that as well.
Yeah, one cable, and then pick your overcurrent protection devices. You're not worrying about, actually, the installation you're currently inheriting as well.
Yeah, and again, just look at another little feature on the enclosure, and obviously we see this on quite common on this type of enclosure. It comes pre-punched out with two modules,
yes,
but you can see you can obviously punch out and take it up to four modules as well and maintain that rating.
Yeah, that's nice. It's sealed as well. Yeah, got sealed. Or you bring your B-type RCD in.
Actually, we've got a five modules, I think. Yeah, we've got two whole ones and then two half ones at the side as well. So
that's good. Yeah. Pretty rare moment to see a B-type RCD as well, isn't it?
You're excited about that, Gary, aren't you?
I was excited about this. This is beautiful. And we saw it in the other videos, didn't we? High end. How can we make an isolator look beautiful? And we saw that black and grey one, didn't we, where we had it against our air source heat pump, and it just blended in beautifully. Top design. What did you think about the Proxima socket that we've shown you today? Have you already fitted one? And you want to leave that in the comments below. What great features did you see on here and you want to share them with the community, and ones that we may have missed? Please leave those in the comments and we'll get back to as many as we can.
Let's get this put back together.
It's nice, isn't it? Innovation.